गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मणिकांत मिश्रा, मॉडर्न इंग्लिश स्कूल, न्यू इंडिया। सो इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द दिस चैप्टर इज मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द केमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ matter, in which the on the basis of the chemical properties matter is classified into pure substance and mixture. We have already discussed a lot about the mixture. Now let us talk about the pure substance. Let me define what is a pure substance. A sample of a matter which constitutes only one kind of atoms or molecules. A sample of a matter which constitute only one kind of atom or molecules is called pure substance. My dear students, I have made use of two terms. A sample of matter which constitute only one kind of atom. Another I said, which constitute of one kind of molecules. It means again, this pure substance may further classified into two categories. So pure substance further divided into two sections. One which constitute only one kind of atom, or another which constitute of one kind of molecules. So now, a sample of matter which constitute only one kind of atom, that is called element, and the which constitute of molecules, that is a compound. So once again, let me one by one clarify it about the element, and then we will go for the next compound. Element is called chemical constituent of all matter, or you can say also element is a fundamental constituent of all matter. Element is a fundamental constituent of all matter. Element is the simplest and purest form of a matter. What I said, element is the simplest and purest form of a matter which cannot split further by any means, like by heating, by hammering, by passing electricity, or by any simple physical or chemical process. Element like sodium, silver, gold, oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, phosphorus, sulfur, these are called element. Once again, all the elements do not have the similar characteristics. So there is a need of further classification. But before it, I tell you, there are 118 elements. There are 118 elements, out of which 92 elements are found in the nature. So the elements which are found in the nature is called natural occurring elements. And rest of the elements, I mean 26 elements, are prepared by man in the laboratory. So those elements are called man-made element or artificial element. So just now, as I said, all the elements are not of the similar properties. So once again, there is a need of the further classification. So elements are broadly classified into two categories, metal and non-metal. And as you have already studied about a lot in class 8, when we say metals, then it comes in our mind is a very hard, malleable, ductile, sonorous, good conductor of heat and electricity. So element which have these kinds of characteristics means elements which are hard, strong, good conductor of heat and electricity, malleability, ductility, luster are called metal. On the other hand, it is a non-metal is opposite of metal. Metals, element which are soft, brittle in nature, generally poor conductor of heat and electricity or bad conductor of heat and electricity are called non-metal. There are 22 non-metals are which generally exist in solid, liquid and gas. Liquid is only one non-metal which is found in the liquid state, that is a bromine. And rest are either solid or gas. It means in the periodic table, there is a dominance of metal, because out of 118 elements, 22 are non-metal and rest of are metals. It means in the world of element, there is a dominance of metal. So elements are broadly classified into two categories, metal and non-metal. But there are few elements which have the characteristics of metal as well as non-metal. That is called semi-metals or metalloid. It is also called borderline element because these elements are existing between the metal and non-metal in the periodic table. So it is often called borderline elements. Element like a silicon, arsenic, tellurium, zirconium are example of a semi-metal or metalloids. Now let us come about the compound. Compound, when two or more elements are combined together in a definite proportion by mass, then compound is formed. So compound is always as a result of chemical combination of two or more elements. So often we call it as a chemical compound. So compound is always formed as a result of a chemical combination of two or more elements. As for example, carbon plus oxygen, carbon combines with oxygen, gives carbon dioxide. So in this in the formation, carbon dioxide is called compound. See, in the formation of compound, the ratio of carbon and oxygen is fixed. Always it is a fixed. In order to form carbon dioxide, 12 gram of carbon has to combine with 32 gram of oxygen. It means the ratio by mass between the carbon and oxygen is 3:8 in order to form carbon dioxide. Now, carbon dioxide has properties entirely different from the carbon as well as from the oxygen. As you know that the carbon is a fuel, oxygen is a supporter of combustion, but new substance so formed, that is a carbon dioxide, neither it acts as a fuel nor it is a supporter of a combustion. So it means the compound so formed has entirely different properties from its constituent element. And this compound so formed has a definite chemical formula to represent. CO2 is the chemical formula, of a carbon dioxide. So thank you. Have a nice day.